Hello, my name's Nick Webb. I worked for 25 years as a paediatric nephrologist. In a few moments, I'm going to be meeting with Gisela, a young patient who has IgA nephropathy, a rare inflammatory kidney disease. Hi Gisela, I'm Nick. It's really nice to meet you.
Oh, it's great to meet you, Nick. I'm looking forward to interviewing you.
That sounds great. Look forward to it too.
So let's get into it. Okay. So it's 1994. I'm 14 years old. I'm rushed to the emergency room because I had just went to the bathroom and I had Coca-Cola urine. You know, 6 months later, that first sign of Coca-Cola urine actually led to a diagnosis via biopsy of IgA nephropathy. How do you explain the disease to a 14-year-old?
I think the first thing that I'd try to do would be to reassure you that nothing that had happened was anything that was to do with you. This was just a really unfortunate development. And that your body's immunity system has become overactive. And through that overactivity has started to cause some problems in your kidney.
My appointments were pretty frustrating because you're always sort of like waiting for one more thing to happen to then treat that thing and not really treating the IgA nephropathy, treating the disease. How does this feel to you as a nephrologist, you know, treating a patient with a sort of incurable disease?
One of the frustrations about kidney medicine is that we're able to control many of the things that the kidney disease causes. So the high blood pressure we can treat, the protein in the urine we can treat, other complications we can treat. But there's been a real shortage of effective and safe medicines that really go after the problem that's causing the kidney to have become diseased in the first place.
I received a kidney transplant from a living donor in February of 2019. Right after surgery, I felt better. But like, how do you sort of explain that, you know, getting a transplant is still a treatment, it's not a cure? And to me, like, I'm constantly telling myself that.
The messages that I give to patients are that you are gonna feel a whole lot better with a transplant than you are on dialysis. Very often I've seen patients with their kidney function back to normal within 4 to 6 hours after the transplant. I do impress on people, I do say this is not, you know, a cure that you just come, have a kidney plumbed in and walk away and that's it. That you are in some ways switching one set of medicines for a different set of medicines. That kidney's got to be looked after and very close attention paid to your treatment.
Well, 2 seconds talking about drugs. I'm gonna take my drugs right now.
Very good. I'm impressed. I'm very impressed.
This is not a game.
Yeah. All right. Here we go. All right. And if I didn't stop, my wife would have ran into the room and been like,
"Told you off."
Yeah, but we take it seriously.
Good, very important. That's why your kidney's doing so well.
So my last and final question for you would be, what are your hopes for the future?
What I'd really like to see is the further development of the compounds that we're working on to treat patients with kidney disease, and with the real aim of preventing people from developing kidney failure, preventing children and adults from needing to start on dialysis treatment and to have kidney transplants. That would be a wonderful goal. But how about you? What are your hopes? What are your dreams for the future?
Yeah, I mean, we're definitely aligned. I think that my hope for the future is in my lifetime. I would love to see it, to see, you know, a 14-year-old patient being diagnosed and then treated and cured. That would be amazing, and not have to have this sort of trajectory of like you're just constantly waiting to get sicker. That would be amazing to see and be a part of.
Yeah. I think our understanding of how these diseases develop have really advanced. Hopefully our wishes and our hopes for the future are completely aligned.
We'll be at that party.
We're celebrating.
Sounds great.
We'll be there together.
Sounds great.